Lakshmibai and Bala Saheb go head to head in the box office today as Manikarnika and Thackeray hit the screens. Both the films have had their share of controversies, but how do they stack up? We give you a sneak peek of both the releases.
This is not just Kangana Ranaut's first period film, it's also her first directorial venture. Queen to thi, Rani ban gayi, Rani Lakshmibai ke roop mein is film mein wo hume nazar aayengi. What is it that I love in the movie? Kangana Ranaut. Thumbs up. There's nothing that she cannot do. Body language, phenomenal. Horse riding career, sword fighting career, emotional scenes mein, like, she's too good. What is it that I did not like in Manikarnika? The film. ऐसे होता है, ऐसा हो गया ना, क्योंकि एक्टर कंगना रनौत अपने भी फोकस करी थी तो डायरेक्टर बागियों को भाव देना भूल गए. तो संजय राउत जो इस फिल्म के राइटर हैं और प्रोड्यूसर हैं, शिवसेना के मेंबर हैं, लेट्स जस्ट एक्सेप्ट इट कि वो सिर्फ अपने बॉस की तारीफ करेंगे. तो वो तो फिल्म में हुआ, बट आई थिंक इट विल बी वेरी वेरी अनफेयर टू टोटली रबिश द मूवी, क्योंकि नवाजुद्दीन सिद्दीकी हैज गिवन हिज करियर बेस्ट परफॉर्मेंस. अब क्या करें, प्रोपेगेंडा फिल्म है बट इट्स अ वेल मेड प्रोपेगेंडा फिल्म.
Following the petitions on the 10% quota bill, the Supreme Court has refused to stay the implementation of the law. The court, however, has said that it will examine the decision and has asked the centre to get back within 4 weeks. On its Chopal journey on the quota, the Quint has now reached Mumbai. Let's hear what students has to say from the capital city of Maharashtra.
इसमें एक दो तीन बातें हैं. पहली बात तो है कि उसमें फंडामेंटल राइट जो है हमारे मूलभूत हक कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के, उसमें अमेंडमेंट हुआ है और वो सेशन के लास्ट के दो दिनों में हुआ है
जी.
तो वो एक तो बात है कि उसके ऊपर सेशन से पहले रिमाइंडर देना चाहिए, नेशन वाइड उसके ऊपर डिस्कशन होना चाहिए था प्रॉपर प्रोसेस से. जो हुआ है वो मतलब उसको किसी ने अपोज नहीं किया और वो पास हो गया लोकसभा में भी राज्यसभा में, मतलब उसको अपोजिशन नहीं, लेकिन उसकी प्रोसेस थोड़ी गलत ढंग से
है. ईवीएम हैकिंग इज वेल एंड ट्रूली बैक इन न्यूज, बट इट वाज बैक इन 2010 that somebody called Hari K. Prasad actually managed to hack an EVM and then got arrested. I have with me Sushovan Sarkar, who talked to Hari K. Prasad. So Sushovan, what is this about?
So in the context of this renewed debate about EVMs and the hackability of EVMs that has come into the picture once again after that dubious press conference in London.
Yeah.
But I mean, it should not take away focus from the more important question, which is, can an EVM machine be hacked? Now, to get a better picture of better answer to this question, it is useful to look at 2010, when this engineer called Hari K. Prasad, along with two other collaborators, one from Netherlands and one from the US, they managed to get hold of an actual EVM, which they had for 24 hours, and they managed to demonstrate two different ways of tampering, manipulating, or hacking the EVM. One way they showed could actually favor one particular candidate and get votes in his or her favor. And the other was the other thing that they showed was how to steal votes or how to extract votes from the machine to show a different vote count than what was actually registered in the EVM machine.
The general elections are just a couple of months away. Remember the build-up around PM Modi the last time elections were around? Well, if you don't, here's a timely reminder of how Mr. Modi hasn't really been fair to what he calls the Latians Delhi.
This hostility towards Latians Delhi is perhaps the most grievous political error. The most grievous political error that Modi has made in an otherwise canny innings as India's most persuasive or proselytizing. You take your pick, Prime Minister. In fact, I would argue that Latians Delhi did more to propel Modi into the Prime Minister's office than any other comparable caucus or support group.
Speaking of elections, Priyanka Gandhi's entry into politics has to be one of the biggest blockbusters this season. The Quint Smita Tharoor talked to people in Chennai on how they feel this development will impact the national politics.
As far as the people of Tamil Nadu is concerned, the entrance of Priyanka Gandhi won't make much difference, because maybe her look is similar to Indira Gandhi, but as far as Congress is concerned, their presence is shrinking in Tamil Nadu. So I think it won't make much difference.
For more news and updates, log on to our website www.thequint.com, and don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe.